part one, chapter two of Sons and Lovers is called The Birth of Paul and Another Battle. Mr. Morel curtails his drinking as the baby's birth grows nearer and he realizes his wife needs his help around the house. When Paul is born, she is very ill, as she was with the other children. Mr. Morel returns from work and is told about the birth. He drinks and eats dinner before going reluctantly upstairs. Mrs. Morel takes solace in her friendship with Mr. Heaton, the minister. She has him to tea and has made him Paul's godfather. Mr. Morel returns home early one night and causes a scene in front of the minister because there's no beer. William hates his father for the way he treats his mother. Shortly after the incident, Mrs. Morel realizes she hadn't wanted another child because of her hatred for her husband. She looks at the baby in her arms and feels a wave of hot love for him and vows to love him all the more now. Mr. Morel returns home drunk one night and tries to take a knife from the drawer to cut his bread. The drawer opens and it falls, cutting him in the shin. He flings the drawer at his wife, hitting her above the eye and causing her brow to bleed. She almost falls but maintains her balance to protect the baby in her arms. The next day, he never says he's sorry, telling himself it was her own fault. Days later, out of money and desperate for a drink, Mr. Morel takes money from his wife's purse behind her back. When she discovers what he's done, she confronts him, but he denies taking anything. Women's and men's roles are apparent when Mr. Morel shows his indifference to the birth of his child and his wife's exhaustion. To him, having babies is what women do. Religion is a powerful force in Mrs. Morel's life. When she has tea with Mr. Heaton, the minister, it's clear that he would have made a more compatible marriage partner for her than her own husband. Mr. Morel's alcoholism threatens the bonds of his marriage. In a drunken fit, he hits his wife with a drawer. Despite her pain and profuse bleeding, Mrs. Morel holds onto the baby in her arms. Throughout the novel, her love for her sons overshadows her feelings for her husband, and her two sons become her preferred lovers, at least symbolically.